Southport was originally an Air Force base. In 1992, when they did close the Air Force base, it was up to the local community, all surrounding community members, to bring back flight training to this area. So Southport, aside from military flight training that happens here, we are also looking to diversify. And of course, UAVs have been on the rise.
Unmanned Systems Canada, we organize this competition every year, and we alternate between here, Southport, Manitoba, and Alma in Quebec to make sure we reach as many students as possible. And the objective is to get as many engineering students to participate, and so that we can try build the industry around this.
Southport is a very nice place to have an event like this. You can have a controlled airspace, have this this competition very, very safely.
The student competition has grown significantly in the last few years. This year the scenario is precision agriculture, and it's certainly fitting, being that we're right in the peak of the market in agricultural country here.
The scenario was, you have a farmer who has a crop area and he's trying to determine the state of health of his crops, and so the technology offers the potential to do overflights, gather this information quickly and remotely in a very short amount of time.
We keep improving the competition every time. We keep increasing the level of complexity and the technical difficulty for the scenario.
It's an art. It has developed my skills as an artist, as an engineer. You have to build each system up and slowly progress through, let's say, code, hardware, mechanical design. It's the number one thing employers look for, is having some kind of student team participation, because you get that technical expertise from actually designing a system fully from the ground up.
It's a world-class event with 18 universities participating this year. It's huge. It's as huge as the competition in the US or in Europe. And it's all about the driving this industry in Canada.
Southport is naturally a center for training, I think mostly because we have so many great facilities here. We not only have a fully functional Transport Canada approved airport, but we also have a number of accommodation facilities, we have a number of meeting facilities on site. Certainly we're looking to be almost a training center of excellence, and unmanned aerial vehicles is another opportunity for us to grow in the future.